Welcome to my projectbuzzer.com. Our title, Risk Assessment in Social Networks Based on User Anomalous Behaviors. This is our abstract. Although the dramatic increase in OSM usage, there are still a lot of security and privacy concerns. In such a scenario, it would be a very beneficial to have a mechanism able to assign a risk score to each OSM user in this paper. We propose a risk assessment based on the idea that the more a user behavior diverges from what it can be considered as a normal behavior, the more it should be considered risky. In doing this, we have taken into account that OSN populations' real heterogeneous in observed behaviors. As such, it is not possible to define a unique standard behavioral model that fits all OSN users' behaviors. However, we expect that similar people tend to follow the similar rules with the results of similar behavioral model. For this reason, we propose a risk assessment organized into two phases. Similar users are first grouped together, then for each INFA group, we build one or more models for normal behavior. The carried out experimental on a real Facebook dataset shows that a proposed model outperforms a simplified behavioral risk assessment, where behavioral models are built over the whole OSM population without a group identification phase. Online social networks allow users to create a public or private profiles, encouraging sharing information and interest with other users and communicating with each other. As a result, OSMs are being used by millions of people and they are now a part of our everyday life. People use OSMs to keep in touch with family, friends and share personal information as well as for business purposes. Users of an OSM build connections with their friends, colleagues and peers over time. These connections form a social graph that controls how information spreads in the social networks. Although there is a dramatic increase in OSM usage, Facebook for instance has now 1.55 billion monthly active users, 1.31 billion mobile users and 1.71 billion daily users. There are also a lot of security privacy concerns. One of the main sources of these concerns is that OSM users establish a new relationship with unknown people with a result of exposure of a huge amount of personal data. Unfortunately, very often users are not aware of this exposure as well as serious consequences. This might result also some users are less concentrated about the information privacy. Therefore, they post more sensitive information on their profiles without specifying appropriate privacy settings, and this can lead to security risk. As a result, today, social networks are exposed to many types of privacy and security attacks. These attacks exploit the ways and processes to collect and expose personal information about their users. When example successfully, conceiving them to click on a specific malicious link with the aim of propagating these links into the inbox. These attacks can either target user personal information as well as the personal information of their friends. Another widely used attack is the generation of fake profiles, which are generated with the sole purpose of spreading malicious content. In addition, there are growing underground markets on OSM for malicious activities is that few of our sins. You can buy Facebook like shares, tweets, followers and fake accounts. Although many solutions targeting one specific kind of attacks have been recently proposed, in instances having a more general solutions that can cope with and mean privacy security attacks that can be penetrated using the social networks graph is missing. In this paper, we make a step towards the definitions of a unique step that helps OSM providers. This is a workflow. First, we will be having a user access, then news feeds. In this news feeds, we will be able to uploading our data sets. In this, we will be having to identify this identifying the data which has been getting into the servers so that we can able to identify the risk assessment as to the news. Okay. And this user behavior. In this user behavior, we will be able to calculating the user behaviors as per the previous and just now. So that by using these calculations, we can able to come into conclusions that we can able to find a user behavior in such a manner so that our risk assessment phase will be get easier with this result of the user behavior. In this risk assessment, in this risk score generation, we will be generating a score which is based on a risk which has been generated based on the user behavior input. After generating a risk score, we will be generating a risk assessment report. Risk assessment report will be telling us that how the risk risk score has been affected the profiles of an users which that risk score, with that risk score we can able to perform the privacy management in a projects. And this is our project, and just right click on and click on run file. we'll be getting this as our home screen. Just click here, we'll be getting a frame that in which we'll be first uploading our data. So first we need to load our data, loaded successfully. Then we need to view the loaded data, viewing process. Next process will be pre-processing. In this pre-processing we'll be removing the null values and data and irrelevant data as per the data which has been get loaded. Pre-process successfully. Okay, data two information detected. Okay, pre-process data will be viewed. Then we'll be classifying our data into a group identification phase. In this we'll be identifying three groups: India, Australia, and South Africa. After clicking India, I'll be getting into a data only a Indian data. How can we say that it's only Indian data? We can able to see a category all one. Category one means India, two Australia, and three South Africa. In this Australia, click OK. I can see a category two data. These are all the data of Australia. In this South Africa, I can get the data of three. It's all the data of South Africa. After in this phase, I can able to get the categories. In these categories, I can able to get India and the status like the categories like photos, etc. Category one, I can able to get the data of relevant to this. If I selected Australia and photos, I can able to get a category 2 data with only a photos, in which we can able to make a clustering process so that we can able to identify our risk identification based on user behaviors. In this behavior analysis, just clicking on this, I will be clicking here Australia and the photos and whose are risk assessment. I'll be calculating the sum and average to identify the normal risk behavior. I have just identified a normal analyzed behavior. By using this behavior, I will be calculating the normal users and anomalous users. Then identifying normal users and anomalous, I will be getting a graph in this. It will be displaying the risk count as per the graph, as per the data which is being get inputted, so that we can able to identify the risk in a graphical manner. Thank you.